So good afternoon, all of you. Please mark your attendance. Sridev and Ijaz, please mark your attendance. Okay, so we are going to discuss the exercise of this lesson. Page number 53 in your textbook. Please take it, take a pencil, and you can mark one word questions and match the following questions in the textbook itself. Descriptive notes I will send to you. You can write it in the notebook. Okay. And Maria, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Miss.
Please mark your attendance. So please take page number 53, exercises in your textbook. Take the pencil also, and you should mark the one word questions and match the following, fill in the blanks answers in your textbook itself. Then descriptive notes should be right in your notebook, okay? So the first question, which of the following can be beaten into thin sheet? What's the answer? Zinc, phosphorus, sulfur, oxygen. What will be the answer?
Zinc.
I can't hear it, Jas. What?
Zinc.
Zinc. Why you choose that answer?
It is metal.
It is metal. Others are the non-metal. So we know that metals can be beaten into thin sheet. What is the property so called?
Malleability.
Yeah, malleability. Malleability is the property of the metal in which can be beaten and made into thin sheet. Then which of the following statement is correct? Second, so tick the answer zinc. First question is answer zinc. Please put a tick mark there. Then second question, which of the following statement is correct? First one, all metals are ductile. All metals are ductile. Then all non-metals are ductile. Generally, metals are ductile. Option D, some non-metals are ductile. Which is the answer? All metals are ductile. Is all metals are ductile? All metals are ductile.
Yes.
You know, some metals are liquid in room temperature. I already told about mercury. Did you remember that? What is the property? Ductility means what? Metals can be? What do you mean by ductility? Why we called it ductile?
Metal can be beaten into thin sheets.
Thin sheets.
Drawn into wires.
Yeah, it can be drawn into thin wires. So we know that all metals are not ductile. Why? We know some, I already said that some metals will be liquid at room temperature. One example is mercury. Shall we break mercury into thin wires? Because it exists as a liquid, but it is a metal. Then how will make into thin wires? We cannot, isn't it? So can we say that all metals are ductile?
No,
we cannot say that all metals are ductile. Ductility is a property of metal, but only some metals have the property. Those metals which can be beaten and broken into thin wires are called ductility. So those metals are said to be ductile. Otherwise, the remaining metals are non-ductile. So option A is wrong, isn't it? Then what about option B? All non-metals are ductile. Is it true?
No.
Okay. So what about C? Generally, metals are ductile.
Yes.
Yes, we can say that generally. It is a general fact, not a exact concept, that it is a general. Generally, we can say metals are ductile, but all metals cannot be ductile. Okay. Did you understand the difference? So generally metals are ductile. That is the correct statement. Which of the following statement is correct? Please tick a put mark. Put a tick mark on the option C. That is generally the metals are ductile. Then next one, question number 3. Sridev, can you please turn on your video? Okay. Please.
Is the voice clear on the network?
Voice. Network issue. Okay. When I ask question, you should turn on the video and give me the reply. Okay. Then question number 3, fill in the blanks. Please take question number 3, fill in the blanks. First one, phosphorus is a very dash non-metal. What's the answer? Phosphorus is?
Reactive.
Yes, it is highly reactive. Did you remember that video that I showed you? Sodium, when reactive, put in water, it will burn. What happened, Sean? What happened?
Nothing, miss.
Who is there to disturb you?
Would you call away or not?
Oh, okay. Then. Faith, why are you so late?
Miss, network issue.
Network problem.
Yes, miss. Okay.
So we are discussing the exercise. Please read the first two answers one more time for Faith. Please, anybody, please read the correct answer. Question and
first
answer.
Okay, which of the four? Can be beaten into clean sheet.
Once more, first one.
Which of the following can be beaten into thin sheets? Sign.
Zinc. Answer is zinc. Faith, mark the answers. Okay. Answer is zinc. Then second question.
Which of the following statement is correct?
Yes. Generally, which of the following statement is correct?
Ductile.
Yes, option C, generally metals are ductile. Then third question, fill in the blanks. Phosphorus is a very reactive. Reaction. Why we say reactive? Because phosphorus, when exposed to air, it will burn. Did you remember that? I'm laughing because of the actions of Sean. He is making some funny moments. Sean, please turn on your video. Okay, listen carefully. Then phosphorus is a very reactive non-metal. Then option B, metals are dash conductors of heat and dash. Metals are?
Good conductor.
Yeah, metals are good conductors of heat and what?
Electricity.
Electricity, right there. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Right there, good and electricity. Then option C, iron is dash reactive than copper. Which is more reactive, iron or copper? Iron is more reactive than copper. Iron is more, M-O-R-E, more reactive than copper. In displacement reaction, we see that copper sulfate and zinc. Indeed. So, in that case, we studied about more reactive metals displaces. Likewise, iron, which is more reactive than copper. Iron also more reactive than copper. Then, metals reactive with the acid to produce what? When metals reactive with the acid, dash gas produced. Which gas?
Hydrogen.
Yeah, hydrogen gas. Right there. Hydrogen gas. Then mark true if the statement is true and false if it is false. First one, A. Generally, non-metals react miss, with the... Yes?
Miss, C on the bar, miss.
Option C. Iron is more reactive than copper. More. iron is more reactive than copper. Okay, question number 4. Mark true if the statement is true and false if it is false. Generally, non-metals react with acid. Is it a true or false statement?
False.
Sean,
false.
Why did you say that it is true statement? Tisa, please turn on your video. I want to see your video. Is it a true statement? Generally, non-metals react with acid. No. Generally, in generally, we can say that non-metals does not react with the acid. That is false. So the second statement, sodium is a very reactive metal. Is it true or false?
True.
True. We know that sodium we kept in kerosene oil. I already said the reason why. Because when it kept in water, it will burn. It is highly reactive because it is highly reactive. Isn't it? So when a substance when reactive with the water, which means it is highly reactive. Okay. So sodium is a very reactive metal. That is a true statement. Right there, true. Then, copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate solution. Is it a true or false?
True.
False. False.
It is a false statement that copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate. It is a false statement. Zinc displaces from copper sulfate. Copper sulfate when reacted with the sulfate displaces from copper, not from zinc sulfate. From copper sulfate
it is false. Miss,
what?
Miss, that is true or false?
Just a minute. Yes, tell me.
Miss, that is true or false? Third one.
That is copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate solution. Is it a true or false statement? That is a false statement. In displacement reaction, we studied about the reaction of a zinc, copper sulfate and zinc. So copper sulfate displaces. Okay. Copper sulfate is the one which displaces and not from zinc sulfate solution, from the copper sulfate solution it displaces. Okay, from the copper sulfate solution, not from zinc sulfate solution. Zinc sulfate solution is the product when formed after the reaction. So displacement taken place from the copper sulfate solution. Okay, so that is a false statement. So the displacement reaction should be studied well, because copper sulfate when reacted with the zinc, the product will be zinc sulfate and copper. So, right, study that very well. Then, coal can be drawn into wires. Is it a true or false? False. Why?
That is metal.
Coal. Coal is a metal?
No, non-metal.
Yeah, that is a non-metal. So, it cannot be drawn into wires. So, coal can be drawn into wires is a false statement. Okay. Did you have any doubt in that 4 points?
Miss, fourth bit 3C nu parayo miss.
C, copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate solution. That is a false statement. From copper sulfate solution, it displaces, isn't it? Not from zinc sulfate solution, from copper sulfate solution, copper displaces zinc. Okay, so here it is said that copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate solution. That is a false statement. It displaces from copper sulfate solution. Okay, that equation is given in page number 51, displacement reaction. You can see that page number 51 in your textbook, the equation is given. Displacement of a copper sulfate to zinc sulfate. Okay, so option C is a false statement, right there, false. Any doubt? No. Shall we move to next question? Okay, then question number 5. Some properties are listed in the following table. Distinguish between metals and non-metals on the basis of these properties. First one, appearance. Appearance of metals and non-metals, hardness of metals and non-metals, malleability, ductility, heat conduction, conduction of electricity of metals and non-metals. Then, first one, appearance. About metals, what is appearance? We said the property of a lustrous, isn't it? So it is hard and looking shiny like a substance. Metals are looking like a shiny substance, isn't it? Gold, silver, etc., aluminium, all these are. So we can say that metals have a metallic luster. It is a metallic shining something. So you can write there it have metallic luster. And non-metals is usually dull, isn't it? In the beginning of this chapter, we studied about the appearance of metals and non-metals. Do you remember that? Properties of metals and non-metals. Yes. Then you can write there appearance in column metals, appearance column metals, you can write have metallic luster, and in non-metals it is dull. And in case of hardness, metals are hard or soft? Metals are hard or hard. So you can write there hardness, hard. Then non-metals are soft. Then what about malleability? Metals are malleable or non-malleable?
Malleable.
Malleable. Right there, malleable. And in non-metals, right, non-malleable. Then what about ductility? What about ductility? Metals are? Tell me.
Non-ductility.
Metals are ductile or not?
Metals by which it can be drawn into wire.
I'm not asking what is ductility. The answer of that column. Ductility is a property of a metal or non-metal. You can write there ductile. Metals are ductile. And below the column non-metal, you can write non-ductile. I will send this column. Okay, after that you can write it in your textbook. Then heat conduction. What about heat conduction? Metals are good conductors of heat. So below that, below the column metals, you can write good conductors. Then non-metals, bad conductors. Okay. Then conduction of electricity. Like heat, metals are good conductors of electricity also. And bad conductors of electricity, non-metals. Okay. And Maria? What happened to Shreya? Why she was absent today?
Miss Shreya carried error.
Tell me. And Maria?
Shreya, class le karumbo connecting kaanik error aanu parna.
Okay. I will send this column. After that, you should write it in your textbook. Don't no need to write in your notebook. You can write it in the textbook itself. Okay. Question number 5, that column. You can write in the textbook itself. Then 6th question, give reason for the following. This question should be write in the notebook. Okay. 6th question answers you must write in your notebook. First one, aluminium foils are used to wrap food item. What is the answer? Aluminium foils are used to wrap the food item. I will say the answer. That is aluminium, which is highly malleable and it can be easily beaten into sheets. It is a malleable metal and it is highly malleable, so it can be beaten into sheets and to make its foil for wrapping purpose. Also soft and does not react with the food items. That is why aluminium foils are used to wrap food items. So in order to wrap food item, we can use aluminium foils because it easily can be broken into sheets and aluminium foils does not react with the food item. That is the reason. Okay. So write the answer in your notebook. Then Second one, immersion rods of for heating liquids are made up of metallic substance. Immersion rods for heating liquids are made up of metallic substance. Why?
Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity.
Yeah, metals are a good conductors of heat and electricity. So we can say that they it is very easy to pass the electric current and with the water. It is very easy to pass the electric current through it. So we can use that. Then copper cannot displace zinc from its salt solution. Why? What is the reason? Why copper cannot displace zinc from its salt solution?
Because it is more reactive.
Which is more reactive, zinc or copper?
Zinc.
Zinc. Because zinc is more reactive than copper. That is, copper is less reactive than zinc. So it cannot displace zinc from its solution. Okay. Then, what about next one? Sodium and potassium are stored in kerosene. Why?
Because it highly reactive with the air.
Yes, because these two substances, sodium and potassium, are highly reactive. And the sodium when reactive with water and potassium reactive with the air. So we cannot keep it in air and water. We keep it aside or water. So we kept it in or stored it in kerosene. Okay, that is the answer. So write these four question answers in your notebook when I send. Okay. Then question number 7. Can you store lemon pickle in an aluminium utensil? Explain. Can you store? Yes or no? Lemon pickle in an aluminium utensil. No. We cannot store lemon pickle in an aluminium utensil. We can store it in glass containers or any steel containers, but we cannot store it in aluminium because because aluminium, which is a metal, and metals readily reactive with acid to produce hydrogen. We know that metals readily reactive with the acid. So the most suitable way to store lemon is either we can store it in a plastic or we can store it in a glass containers. Okay, because otherwise, what will happen? It is highly reactive. Which acid in lemon? Which acid is there? Lemon contains citrus acid. Do you know that? Lemon contains citrus acid. So the acid contained in the lemon, which are reactive with this metal. So we did not keep it in any metal like aluminium or a steel like that for a long time. We can just use for 1 hour, for 1 to 2 hours, but for a long time we cannot keep it in a steel or any metal container. Okay, only use glass or a plastic containers for keeping lemon pickled. Then match the substances given in column A with their uses given in column B. Match the following. First one, gold. What is the answer?
Jewelry.
Yeah, jewelry. Then iron.
Machinery.
Yes, machinery. Market. Faith, market. Answer. What about aluminium?
Wrapping food.
Yeah, wrapping food. Then carbon.
Fuel.
Yes, carbon as a fuel. Then copper.
Electric wire.
Mercury.
Thermometer.
Thermometers.
Yes, mercury used in thermometers. Then 9th question. What happens when dilute sulfuric acid is poured on a copper plate? What happened when dilute sulfuric acid? You can think it. What happened when dilute sulfuric acid poured in a copper plate?
No reaction will happen.
No reaction. Because what? Why? Why there is no reaction? Copper is a metal. Then why it does not react with acid? Do you know the reason? We study that the metal, all metals will be reacted with acid. Then copper is a metal. Then why there is no reaction will given? It is that copper is less or more reactive?
Less.
Copper is a less reactive metal. That is, we
Miss can't hear.
Can you hear me? Okay. So I said that copper is less reactive. Copper is a less reactive metal. In fill in the blanks, see, we write that iron is more reactive than copper. The other metals like iron, zinc, all these are more reactive than copper. And copper is a less reactive metal. Remember the exceptional cases, okay? All these are the exceptional cases. Copper is a less reactive metal. That is one exceptional case. And sodium reactive with the water. Potassium react in air. All these are some exceptional cases. Mercury is a metal, but it exists in liquid state. Okay, all these are the exceptional cases. So remember it carefully. Remember the fact that copper is a less reactive metal. So when some questions asked related with the copper, the reactivity of copper, you can write that it is because it is a less reactive metal. So it does not react with any acid. Okay, understand? Did you understand that point? Anne Maria, did you get the point? What? Any doubt? No. What about Sean? Just and Faith? No. Okay. Then the second one, 9th question. B. Iron nails are placed in copper sulfate solution. Write word equation for the reaction involves. Iron nails are placed in copper sulfate solution because the answer is, you know the displacement reaction. Do you remember the displacement reaction? Because iron being more reactive than copper, which will replace copper from its solution. So iron is more reactive than copper. When we keep iron nails in copper, what will happen? It will replace copper from the solution. It replaces copper from the solution and the brown coating of the copper is deposited on the iron nail. Do you remember that experiment shown in a test tube? The two nails that dipped in a copper solution. Then after some time when it turned, this color becomes changed. It is a brown color. Do you remember that? Yes, that is the reason. Because when iron, which is more reactive than copper, and it replaces copper from its solution, and a brown coating of a copper is deposited on the iron. Okay, it replaces copper. Iron replaces copper. That's the reason. So iron, when reactive with the copper sulfate, iron sulfate and copper will be formed. The compound may be displaced from one to other. That is displacement reaction. Okay, A plus B C, which means after the reaction, what will happen? B will change it to A. B will displace to A. So AB plus C will be formed. Do you remember that equation I shown in the video? Okay. Then, 10th question. Saloni took a piece of burning charcoal and collected the gas evolved in a test tube. How will she find the nature of the gas? I will read the answer. That is, she can find the nature of the gas by using a wet litmus paper. After burning, bringing the litmus paper in contact with the gas, it turns blue litmus paper into red when it is acidic. Similarly, if we turn the red litmus to blue, it is basic. So we can say that for checking the nature of a substance, we can use a litmus paper. We can use blue litmus and a red litmus papers. When red litmus turn to blue, we can say that the solution is what? Red turn to blue. What will be the solution?
Basic.
Yeah, basic. When blue turns to red, we can say that it is acidic. Okay. So write the equation. Write down the word equation. Equation is that is carbon plus oxygen, which gives carbon dioxide. Burning means carbon. Carbon. The burning product will be carbon, and when it react with oxygen, it gives carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide when react with the lime water, what will happen? It is turns milky. That's answer I have sent you. Then the question number 11. One day, Rita went to a jeweler shop with her mother. Her mother gave an old gold jewelry to the goldsmith to polish. Next day, when they bought the jewelry back, they found that there was a slight loss in this weight. Can you suggest a reason for the loss in weight? Can you suggest a reason? Did you have any such experience when we went with the jeweler's shop with any jewelry, any type kind of gold jewelry? Then sometimes its weight may be lost. Why? The reason is that the jewelry may be dipped into an acidic solution. When it is dipped, when gold like metal which is dipped into an acidic solution for pollution, what will happen? The outer layer of the gold which dissolves and the inner shiny layer appears. So this causes a loss in weight. So the outer layer of the gold will disappear when it dip in an acid solution, because we said that metals react with the acid. So when gold, when dipped in an acidic solution, what will happen? The outer layer, outer polish will be lost. So it may cause loss in weight, weight loss. Okay. When I send the descriptive notes, you should write in your notebook. Okay. Also, write one word question answers in the textbook itself. Please mark it correctly. If you have any doubt, you can check after I sending the notebook. Okay. So don't make any note in pending. Write after I sending, or maybe on to tomorrow evening. Before tomorrow evening, I will send you the notes, and you should write in tomorrow, day after tomorrow itself. Till Saturday evening, I give you time to write. Okay. Before Saturday evening, you should write your notes and send me back. There is no excuse. On the next class, when I ask to you, did you write your note? Don't give any reply that I didn't miss. I don't accept that. Okay. So our time is over. Now you can leave from the meeting. Please read the textbook at least 5 times. This chapter is over. In the next class, I will ask you questions. Okay. So materials, metals, and non-metals. It is very important chapter. You may cause confusion sometimes, but there are so many reactions are there. So read the chemical reactions very well and study it. Okay. Okay, all. Now you can leave from the meeting. Our time is going to over. Thank you. Thank you all. Bye.